welcome to this Divot Derby matchup. We got to get to the hole as fast as we can. Let's do this now. And on this hole, the slowest three golfers will not make it to the next hole, so we got to be speedy out there. Let's go, let's go. Clock is ticking. Time is money. Well, time is XP. That's too bad. Timer's going. Maybe one more putt.
This one's tracking.
All right, three slots left. And it drops, and we're heading to the next. And there we go. Final slot has been taken. Okay, you made it through the first hole of this one. Let's continue. On this hole, we have 17 golfers and only 14 slots. Uh-oh, clock's a ticking now. We gotta get a move on. Okay, let's try another shot. Time's running out. Okay, clock's ticking. Let's get another shot off here. Only four slots left. And now three left. Two left. Ooh, timer's going. Maybe one more go. Yes, we did it. We will continue. Okay, 13 players remaining in the group as we tee up. On this hole, two people will be eliminated. Could be more. Let's make this putt. It's lengthy. Well, let's see if you can try another putt. That clock is ticking, though. Six slots remaining to continue. We got to get going. And we will head to the next hole. Great work out there. And there goes the final slot in this one. Okay, and that's three holes down. On this one, we have 11 golfers and only 9 available slots. Clock's ticking now. Let's get this thing going. Okay, clock's ticking. Let's reload. Okay, let's do this. Six slots remaining. We gotta move. Whoa, someone dropped a huge putt in there. Nicely done. Nine people left as we tee off on this hole. two people getting the axe on this hole. At the very least, could be more if people don't make that buzzer. And that clock just started ticking. Let's get to the hole. All right, five slots remaining in this one. Now just three left. And there we go. Final slot has been filled. Next. And the group is down to seven players as we tee up this next shot. Slowest two players on this hole will not make it. Could be more if people don't make that buzzer. Hope somebody hold out. Clock is ticking now. Oh, countdown's going. Maybe one more chance at this. Come on. Only three slots left.
Sports and the PGA Tour are delighted to bring you the season-long race for the FedEx Cup. Today's coverage of the Farmers Insurance Open is about to begin. Hello, I'm Luke Elvey alongside 2002 PGA Championship winner Rich Beem, who's in the booth. And it's a hello to Henny Koyak down on the course following our featured group.
Hi Luke, I'm very happy to be following this particular featured group because there are rumours of quite the rivalry starting to bubble between these two players.
Well, it looks like this player is aiming to beat Lexi Thompson, which very few people can boast. This should be an exciting showdown, Henny.
Luke, Lexi's young but has been on tour for about 30-40 years it seems. She's been playing forever, she doesn't lack an experience, she can do it all. Not to mention, you'll be looking at her back for most of the day because she'll outdrive you.
Yes, Lexi loves the long ball and so do we. Good luck in this rivalry because when Lexi gets on top, it's very hard to beat her. And he's down there.
Setting up here from about 140 yards. Wow, that one was a fairway splitter.
Looks like they're going with the pitching wedge. And here we are with the third shot. Take that. That's quality. Certainly makes putting easy if you can chip it that close.
Great touch.
He's currently tied for 10th. The second, a short par four, one that the players like to take on these days, Rich. A good birdie look here.
They do. It used to be where you laid back on top of the hill and took a wedge, nine iron sometimes for your second shot, but a lot of players now are challenging that bunker down the right-hand side, getting as far down there as possible, and just having a flick with a sand wedge in for their second.
Good shot there, Beamer. Second shot on the second.
No harm, no foul there with that shot.
Now moving over to Lexi Thompson.
It's been so tight. She's tied here with her rival. And can she pull ahead now?
7 feet to the cup. That's pretty tidy. That's inside the range. Solid play. Finds that player moving up the leaderboard after that hole. There are so many stunning golf holes on this entire property, and this third, the par three downhill, certainly one of the elite holes on the course.
It might be stunning to look at, but it is painful. Can be extremely painful to play. Downhill all the way, when they tuck the pin over on the left-hand side, forget about it. Never hit it there. Only when the pin is on the center or the right part of the green should you be taking dead aim. Other than that, center of the green all day long.
That's a good shot by him. He'll be delighted. Putting for birdie. Go on, get in the hole. Ooh, right by the hole. And this putt coming up for his par. The putt drops, and we're moving on. Currently one under for the event. One of the hardest holes on the entire property is the par four, fourth, Rich. It is a strong, demanding hole right from tee to green.
Very picturesque, this fourth hole. Pacific Ocean directly to the golfer's left-hand side. Don't be sucked in by the views, however. You'd want no part of that. And you certainly don't want any part of that fairway bunker down the right-hand side either. Find the fairway, and you've got a good chance at knocking it on this green in two. Be wary, though. Anything long and left on this green is no good.
That's some good golf right there. And Henny, what's he looking at here?
Yeah, this is straight back into the breeze. Going to be a tough one.
This one needs to kick left and kick left hard.
Well, a little off the target with that one.
Yeah, wind took that one offline in a hurry.
Wow, really had that shot dialed in. Well, you like the look of those hands.
Judging it beautifully.
Just a tiny putt is all that remains. John, you're down there. What's happening?
Hey guys, we are checking in down here with Justin Rose as he gets set for his next shot here on the fifth.
Oh, great shot. Holes out for a birdie. That'll help make a big move. Let's take a look at the leaderboard as it stands. Our current leader is enjoying a one-shot lead. There's a real premium on your tee shots here at Torrey Pines South Course. Keeping ball in fairway is critical, and that is illustrated also by the par 4 fifth.
This fairway cambers from left to right, which helps a fade on this hole. However, don't get too overzealous and pull it, because that fairway bunker down the left, that sees a lot of action. Second shot is a green that pitches back toward you from back to front. That's got a lot of movement over on the left-hand side.
And Henny, what's he looking at here?
This breeze just starting to blow, but it's a helpful breeze. It's one that you like. Got a club down a little bit.
Chosen the pitching wedge here. Oh, that's a high caliber shot. This putt for the lead. Oh, so close. And this putt to move into a share of first place. Our work here is done. Let's head to the next hole. He's currently in a share of top spot. Rich, there are a number of strong holes on this outward half, but the par 5 sixth, the players are definitely thinking birdie here, but it's all set up by the tee shot.
It's a nice reprieve, this par 5. Just a little bit dogleg from left to right. Keep it shy of those fairway bunkers down the left-hand side, and almost every player will give it a go in two. This is a three-tiered green with a low area over on the left-hand side that sees a lot of action.
Well, with a pocket full of FedEx Cup points over the last half a dozen starts or so, this player certainly has been delivering consistent results and pushing for wins or winning, Rich. Do you expect that to continue here this week?
It's never a surprise when you speak this player's name. They've been so good all year long. They've got to be one of the favorites, not only for this tournament, but for also for the season-long FedEx Cup.
Let's take a look at Lexi Thompson, shall we?
She's currently trailing her rival. Let's see what happens here.
And there it goes from the sand. Getting ready to play their third. Currently tied for the lead. Wow, that almost went in the hole. This putt is about 8 feet.
This is their look at birdie.
Good stroke. Yeah, nice mid-range birdie putt, that one. And that will take him to 2 under. He finds himself in a share of the lead. The par 4 seventh, a little dogleg left to right. Again, positioning off the tee is key.
This fairway slopes pretty good from left to right. Players want to start it out at the fairway bunker down the left-hand side and just hit a gentle fade off of that. Second shot here is to an elevated green. Don't go long whatsoever here. That's when the Barranca and the Canyons come into play.
That swing so pure, it reminds me of Adam Scott's. The ladies' game has been dominated by Koreans for such a long time, but America has been able to have this resurgence basically off the back of Lexi Thompson and the generation she's started to inspire.
Lexi Thompson is so fun to watch because she's got a very unique swing, and when you look at it, you kind of look back and you go, okay, that went a long way. Okay, that went right at the hole. And she's got such control over her golf ball, it's amazing. And the wins are going to continue to pile up for her year after year. I'm blown away by the fact that she is so aggressive on every single shot. There is no laying up in her game, and I love that. Now, that might cost her a few wins, but I tell you what, she's going to have a lot of wins because of that as well. I love the way she plays the game. It's exciting.
Big putt for par coming up. just one off the lead after that hole. We head up the hill away from the ocean here at the eighth hole, Rich. A lovely par three, but all the challenges in the green.
It is. It's very wide, not very deep. Players going in there with kind of mid irons to short irons. Uphill the entire way. Difficult to get it on that back level when they stick the pin all the way on top.
That got a little out of control, I think.
And coming up well short.
And the players left with an opportunity to get up and down here from the sand. Oh, almost went in. And back to the course with the live action. This would be a great up and down. Oh, wouldn't that have been nice? And this would be a great par putt if you can make this. Oh, nice looking putt. Oh, a little bit of a rush of blood by the looks of it. Down she goes. Let's head to the next. Currently one under for the tournament. The par 5 ninth is a monster over 600 yards, Rich. Challenging to say the least.
I think the challenging part about it, Lucas, is just straight away. You have to hit a straight tee shot, a straight second shot, and a straight third shot to find the green in three. It really is just that simple and straightforward. The green does have two tiers on it. But for the most part, Luke, it's an inviting third shot.
Rich, we know these days with the PGA Tour, the wraparound schedule, the tour begins in the fall. But really, it's felt at the start of any new year that every time you come to Torrey Pines, the big stars come out to play. It feels like the authentic start to the season.
It certainly does that. And I think that the big name players, the accomplished players, love coming here to Torrey Pines because it's going to give them a gauge of exactly where their game is at and what they need to work on. Because you can't go around either the north or the south course and geek it around. You have to be on your game. You have to drive the ball well. Your iron play has to be spot on. And your short game better be sharp, because if not, you're going to shoot a million. Both of these golf courses, very challenging, but they're fair. And I think that's what the players love about it. If you're in a good zone mentally and everything is going well physically, you can produce a 64 or 65. But if you're hitting it poorly and you're not thinking squarely, I'm telling you what, 77s and 78s come into the equation real quick.
This is Lexi Thompson.
What a shot! Almost went in the bucket. And she's holed it. Absolutely magnificent.
And now this is why you can never get comfortable, even if you're leading a PGA Tour pro. This is what they do. They mean business.
This is the transition point of the round, making the turn, heading for home. How do you rate this player's performance so far?
Two strokes off the lead with nine to go, Luke. They're going to need to put something special together.
This one looks to be headed towards the fairway.
Correction, mate. This one ended up in the sand. Oh, Henny, that looks like a putrid lie. Is it bad?
Yeah, this is not what they wanted. There might be a couple of hits here.
And here we are with the third shot. Only two shots off the pace. Oh, I thought that one was going in. This putt is of 9 feet. If it's up, it could be in. And in she goes. That's a good save.
Nicely done. Well fought hole right there. Bunkered off the tee, but makes that nice par save.
Our current leader is enjoying a 2-stroke lead. There aren't too many easy holes here at Torrey Pines South, but the course certainly gets tougher as we head to the par 3 11th.
This green from the back tee looks minuscule. There's just not a lot of room on the front of it. Even the back section, which it does get a little bit wider, it still is very small. A massive shelf, top left. If you get it up there, happy days for you. If not, just find the green, two putt, make three, move on.
Going with the 5-wood. Yeah, quality shot that. This putt will move them to 3 under par.
This is what they have left for birdie here.
Was on a good line. Just a 4-footer remaining. Good looking putt. Now moving over to Lexi Thompson.
Yeah, she's down, she's behind, her rivals scooting ahead. Let's see what happens.
Oh, that's clutch. What a way to save your par.
Oh, a messy little lie in the bunker, but that is not a problem for this player. Yes, in the hole.
Our leader is a couple of shots up at this stage. We head to the 12th hole. This par 4 is as big and as strong and as tough as you find anywhere on the PGA Tour.
This is about as tough a hole as you're going to find anywhere on the planet. Prevailing wind coming right back into the players. You just have to step up and hit a solid tee shot to find the fairway. From there, you're going in with a mid to long iron, sometimes even a hybrid, to a green that sits just above you. Not a ton of movement, but enough from back right to front left to make you think.
Opting for the 5-wood. Well, they'd love a little bounce to the right here. A wonderful shot and a birdie opportunity coming up at the 12th.
You know what? That deserves a golf clap.
Here's Lexi Thompson. Well, that's a beautiful bunker shot there. Okay, let's get back to it, shall we? What are we looking at for this putt, Henny?
Straight back up this hill. Can be firm here.
This one's tracking. Nice one. Fourth birdie of the day. And with that, he'll move to 3 under par. And that finds him in a share of second.
Well now, things have gotten interesting. Closing the gap.
All right, Rich. The par 5 13th. So much has been said about it. I'm interested in your thoughts.
This is one of the most interesting par 5s you'll ever play. If you hit a good tee shot, find the fairway, and you have the opportunity to reach, then happy days. But if you don't find the fairway or can't reach, now you've got to lay up into a low area where you're going to have a third shot that's absolutely blind. This third shot could be one of the most difficult third shots on the PGA Tour, bar none.
Oh, you couldn't paint a better picture. Gorgeous. Four victories so far this season. Getting ready to play their third. Just one stroke back and right in it. Sitting at minus three, tied for second place. Putting for par.
Yep, tracking nicely.
For the par. No movement up or down on the leaderboard for this player. Time to take a look at what this par 4 might be in order. Playing from around 150 yards here.
Breeze straight into him.
Opting for the 9-iron. Looks like this one's going to the beach. That was a little bit of a misfire, I'd say.
Wynn got that one and took it wayward.
Here's Lexi Thompson. Oh, my. Oh, dear. Can he get out of here?
This reminds me of my breakfast. Nice fried egg.
Whew. Now about the concentration to pull that shot off. Let's see if he can make this. Keep the par on the card. Hey, that's a chance. That gets the job done. Trailing by a stroke after that hole.
We stride across the 15th, Rich, and we talk about strong par fours. This is another one.
As big as 12 was, Luke, this is almost twice the size, if you can imagine it, with a tiny, tiny landing area out there. This is possibly the meanest hole on this golf course. Not hardest, meanest. If you've walked off with par on this hole, job well done, my friend.
That looks to be a fairway finder to me. Playing this shot from around 220 yards here, and only one off the pace here. Looks like they've got the 5-wood. Well, take notes, folks. That's how you do it. Always love these opportunities, especially when it's for birdie. This one started out on a good line. Don't want to state the obvious, Rich, but a little too hard, that one. In the end, that will be a disappointing par after such a great approach shot.
And that would have tied the lead for this player. Disappointing, to say the least.
Well, that's got to have some impact on the scoreboard. Let's take a look. And now at 3-under overall. 16th, the last of the par threes on this golf course, but it's not an easy one.
This is underrated difficult. The green is big in size, but it plays awfully small because there's really small sections to this green. The front, the back right, and the top left. If you find the right section, job well done. If you don't, it's going to be a difficult two-putt, to say the least. Yep, that'll work. That's fine.
Well, this is an important putt for the tournament here, Rich.
Certainly is. Let's watch it unfold, Luke.
Ouch, that hurts. A 7-footer right here.
It's looking solid.
Nicely holed, and for par. Trailing by a couple of strokes now. The penultimate hole at Torrey Pines South is not a long par four, but the danger lurks everywhere.
They moved this fairway to the left alongside the canyon a few years ago, which really enhanced the beauty, but also the fear of this hole. You have to challenge the left-hand side because the bunker down the right is really no good. From there, the green, it tilts from back to front, mostly with a really low section over there on the left-hand side. However, it still is a promising birdie opportunity.
Well, Rich, this player is certainly making moves up the leaderboard, aren't they?
Absolutely. Nice push on this final round. Still needs to keep the foot on the gas, continue making birdies if they have any hope of winning.
Going with the 9-iron, I think. This one looks to be a tad wayward. Attaboy, good shot. A chance to get up and down for this player. Didn't that look good for a long time? A par putt awaits.
Always rooting for this player, Luke. I hope this one goes.
The leader now has a one-stroke advantage. And the finishing hole here at Torrey Pines South, one of the more famous on the PGA Tour, site of so many of Tiger's wonderful victories. par five. You can get there in two.
You can, but you have to thread your drive in between those four fairway bunkers that line the fairway. From there, now you have to think, do I want to take on this flag with the bunkers right, bunkers left, and certainly the water in front? It's a daunting second shot, but if you're brave enough to take it on, then you could reap massive rewards.
Well, that's a handy shot. The equation's pretty simple. Chip this in and win the tournament. Oh, so close, Rich. That chip almost went down for them.
How did that stay out, Luke? That chip looked...
And there it is, Rich. We're going to extra holes now. Well, Rich, it's time to find out who will win this in a sudden death playoff.
Oh, everybody loves a playoff, Luke. I'm excited about this.
Well, it's going to take sudden death to decide this title. Let's go, Rich.
Luke, I'm ready. Let's go.
It's time for a one-shotter.
Well, this player had a par earlier on this hole in regulation, Luke. Not too sure that's going to be good enough in this playoff.
Opting for the hybrid, I think.
This one headed left in a hurry.
Oh, and that's a missed green in a playoff. Hopefully they can regain their composure. Ooh. Oh, that was an absolute beauty, particularly out of that lie. That's a touch of class.
Love watching this player around the greens.
Oh, Rich, that's got a sting. A chance for the victory, but it goes begging.
Nope, always a tough pill to swallow, losing in any way. But losing in a playoff, ooh, that stings.
Well, thank you, sports fans. Hope you enjoyed all the coverage of our playoff finale. And from myself and all the dedicated people at 2K Sports, thanks for tuning in. Catch you next time. Thank you.
UK Sports, in association with the PGA Tour, proudly presents the season-long race for the FedEx Cup. Today's coverage of the AT&T Pebble Beach Pro-Am is about to begin. I'm Luke Elvey alongside Rich Beam in the booth, and it's a hello to Henny Koyak down on the course following our featured group.
Hi Luke, I'm looking forward to bringing you the action from the ground level for this week's featured group. Now there's a sense of heightened competition this week, and this player has mentioned that they're starting up a rivalry this week with their playing partner.
Well Henny, it sounds like this player's going for gold. They're trying to beat Xander Schauffele.
I wouldn't want to try and beat an Olympian. A gold medal winning Olympian with hair as good as Xander Schauffele and a swing as good as Xander Schauffele? No, no thank you. I'll leave this up to them.
Yes, I'm just looking through his list of weaknesses and let me just list them off now. Yep, none. Good luck to you.
Nicely done.
Rich, a little bit of undulation change here at the opening hole.
The ball will be below the player's feet on this approach to the first green, so they need to take that into consideration. You might want to play for a little bit of a slice shot.
They're looking to get this one close in hopes of saving par. I like that. Always good when you've got hands like that around the green.
Yes, very smooth tempo there on that chip.
And as we head to the second tee, the first of the par fives, and as we talked about, you've got to get off to a great start at Pebble Beach.
Absolutely, a par five that almost every player should be able to reach into. Just avoid the bunkers right and left, and you're going to have a clean shot into a very narrow green.
Oh, good drive. That one should find the fairway. And what's in front of them there, Henny?
A little bit of breeze ruffling the old hair, and it's coming straight on.
Oh, that was so close to going in.
are this type of carriage, Rich, going for it in two.
Two big hits there, knocking it on this par five and two.
What's in front of them, Henny?
Setting up this putt 21 feet from the cup. Their boldness paid off. They've got this for the eagle.
This one looking really good.
Appears to have overcooked this one.
8 feet to the cup. Nice stroke. Oh, what a super shot. Currently one under for the day. Here we are at the third.
Coming off a birdie at the last, looking to add another one.
Absolutely flushed. Second shot here on the third. Going with the pitching wedge here.
Wow, they really put on a show with that approach shot, and their rival, Xander Schauffele, appears to be taking notice as well.
So far, so good.
That will work on a roll here with back-to-back birdies.
That's a momentum maker, isn't it?
Back-to-back birdies move in the right direction there, Luke.
Now heading over to Xander Schauffele.
He's feeling good. Just birdied the last hole.
Xander Schauffele setting up his next shot.
Well, that should save him. That one from the sand.
Let's take a look at the leaderboard. Colin Morikawa currently in the lead as we check the rest of the standings.
Rich, we get our first look at the beach here at Pebble Beach. This fourth is a short one, but beguiling.
It is, just around a 325-yard mark. Most players tend to lay up and just have a wedge for their second. However, the big sticks, they can go ahead and take a rip at it, but beware, the beach lurks closely down the right-hand side.
Few players in the history of the game have had a bigger impact so early in their career than Colin Morikawa, Rich. Some comparisons go as close to Tiger Woods.
As they should be currently right now with what he has done in the game so far in his young career. He's come out each and every week and put pressure on every single player because of his ball striking and because they know that there's no weaknesses in his game. Other than sometimes the putter, but when you hit it as good as he does, you're bound to make a putt now and again. And each and every week when he shows up, players on the driving range are looking at him going, okay, he's here. I got to have my A game.
Certainly feels like sky's the limit for Colin Morikawa.
Two major championships under his belt right now. Surely more in his future.
It's tracking. Ooh. An opportunity to make a par here.
Just one off the lead after that hole. The fifth hole, Rich, the first of the par threes. Much to it?
There is. This green is tiny. It's minuscule. And you have what over to the right-hand side? Oh, yes. The Pacific Ocean. No, thank you.
A par three here is an excellent score.
Going with the hybrid. And he's hit that inside the range.
Already had a few birdies today. Another opportunity for another one. Let's take a look.
And this putt for a share of the lead. This one's dialed in. Oh, gee, that line was looking good, wasn't it? A par putt on the table. Yeah, well hold. Let's move on to the next. Currently a couple under for the event. The sixth hole here, Richard Pebble Beach, is a tale of two halves, isn't it? A strong tee shot down the hill towards the ocean, and then the second, the approach shot back up the hill.
There's no doubt about it, Luke. This is just a spectacular par five. The beauty of it, though, is that you can mess it up in a hurry. This is a very difficult par five. Don't make any bones about it.
That's a good-looking shot there. Do you like the view from where you're standing, Henny?
You're going to need one or two clubs more because this green is sitting up.
Going with the five wood. Well, that's a pretty good play there, Rich. Right up near the surface.
It's an aggressive play, Luke. Like to see it on this par five.
Close was that to going down? 5 feet coming up to the cup. Not a bad line, this. And that will drop in for a birdie. And that will take him to three under. We'll now move over to Xander Schauffele.
Yeah, he just made bogey on that last one.
This is one of those lengthy putts. Good one just to get close. And after that effort, this is how the leaderboard looks. We head across to the par three, seventh. We always talk about it in golf. It doesn't need to be a long one to be a great one.
Luke, this could be one of the most picturesque par threes in all of golf. Who says great par threes need to be more than 150 yards? Not a single one of them. I love this hole.
This is one of those great ball striking displays, fairways and greens. A pleasure to watch.
It's amazing to see how good this player is in full flow.
That was a gallant attempt. Just 3 feet to go to the hole. Don't miss this. They can be costly.
This is important. Big par putt here.
He's currently tied for second. Well, after the beauty of the seventh, we go to the beast that is the eighth. Is there a tougher two-shotter on the property?
Not to my knowledge, no. At just around 425 yards, you're going to lay up to the end of the fairway. No driver needed, but the second shot is where it gets difficult. Downhill, a very small green. You knock it on here in two, and you've done well. That dog will hunt.
Time for the second shot at the eighth. Game with the seven. Could roll into the rough on this one. That was a bit of a miscue.
Well, that's a strange miss there. Look, they've been hitting the greens all day long.
Wow, that almost went in the hole. Big par saver coming up for this fella. And down it goes. Let's head to the next. Now heading over to Xander Schauffele.
Now, who'd have thought we'd see this? He is behind his rival. Can he do the catching up that's necessary?
Trailing by a stroke after that hole. Pebble Beach has a terrific stretch of par four, starting from the eighth right through to the end of the 11th. Let's take a look at the ninth.
This is an interesting hole because it wants to make you aim left, but there's a bunker there that you need to avoid. Funny enough, there's a lot more room out to the right than what you can see off the tee. A very strong par four to finish the front nine.
Xander Schauffele, delightful player out of San Diego, California. He's got that cool vibe about him. Came out one early a few times, but then he seems to have struggled to find that next step, hasn't he? He's sort of golf's almost man, except when he got that gold medal put around his neck.
I think that took his confidence to a place where it should have been in the first place, Luke. I think that this young man, he's got no weaknesses, very little weaknesses, if anything, in the game. I look at him and think, why hasn't he won more? Well, the problem is that he's put himself in contention so many times that there's only one person in the game that has won at a clip that he could have, and that's Tiger Woods. When you put yourself into contention as often as he does, you're just not always going to win. Somebody is going to come from back in the pack, shoot a great round, and you might struggle just a little bit, whatever the case. But yes, he hasn't closed as many tournaments as he would have liked, but he is there each and every week. I got to say, this kid is, he's a world beater. He's going to be phenomenal.
Well, Rich, this is the pivotal final nine coming up, and the players perfectly positioned. They've given themselves a chance.
Well, Luke, it's been fun watching this player duke it out with their rival, that's for sure. They're winning the rivalry thus far. Should be fun to see where these two end up at the end of the event.
Oh, great swing there. This shot is about 140 yards out.
Puff of breeze moving this golf ball left to right.
Choosing the 9-iron here.
Club up. I like this play. The perfect wind swing. Nice and easy.
And this putt will take them to 5-under.
This for a birdie run. What a putt. Started this perfectly.
Oh, just missed. And that should secure the par on this one. And as they leave that hole, Rich, you'd imagine a little bit frustrated after such a great shot in. Here's Xander Schauffele.
Wind's blowing from left to right. Gonna try and hold it against the wind.
And there's no movement on the leaderboard after that hole. Well, Rich, we start to head home, but first we've got to head up the hill on this short par 4 11th.
Thankfully, a breather hole after the last few. This is just a 3-wood. Could be a driver up the hill. Second shot, very short, but beware, this green pitches severely from back to front. Watch the spin on your second shot. Lovely, lovely rhythm.
Sitting at minus 4 in a share of the lead. This one looks to be heading towards the green. A wonderful shot. A chance for birdie here on the 11th.
Nearly doesn't get any better than that. Amazing shot. Right over the spot they were looking at.
We'll now move over to Xander Schauffele.
He's currently trailing his rival. Let's see what happens here.
Scorecard filled with threes never hurts. Good putt to make this.
This is, yeah.
And how did that shot impact the score? Let's have a look at the leaderboard. Our current leader is enjoying a one-shot lead. The first of the back nine par threes is the 12th.
And this is a mean one, not gonna lie, it's mean. It's right around 185 yards, but the green, once again, very tiny. You come up short in that deep bunker, you're bound to make a 4.
Looks to be going with the 5-iron. Oh, that one just missed the hole. Outstanding approach shot.
This one here, this is for back-to-back birdies, moving him in the right direction.
Yep, tracking well.
Geez, making this look easy. Keeps surging ahead. Back-to-back birdies never hurt Rich.
I like it. He's feeling it.
And a quick look at the leaderboard has this player currently in first spot, with Tony Finau second. Rich, let's head to the 13th tee at Pebble Beach, shall we? And what's the decision off the tee?
Aim it right, just shy of those bunkers down the right-hand side, and you've got a mid-iron for your second shot back up the hill. Again, a green that pitches severely from back to front as well as right to left.
Nicely done. Sitting at 6-under for the day. Outright first here. Going with the 8-iron here. Wonderfully played. And he's down there. You got a read?
Has to putt this one downhill.
Well, it's a bit disappointing. This putt's about 4 feet from the hole. Yeah, we'll take that. Now heading over to Xander Schauffele.
Now, who'd have thought we'd see this? He is behind his rival. Can he do the catching up that's necessary?
Okay, steady now. And let's see what that shot did to the leaderboard. The leader now has a one-stroke advantage. As we head to the 14th, I know the 18th gets all the attention here at Pebble Beach, but this is a strong par 5.
Oh, this is a good one. I love this par 5. Just hit it just down the left-hand side. You can't reach the far bunkers down the left. Lay up with a long iron, maybe a fairway wood, but watch out. This third shot gets awfully tricky.
Disappointing, that one. Setting up in the first cut. Not bad. Well, Rich, this won't come as a big surprise, will it? Because there's a lot of people talking about this player. They've been performing beautifully all season, and many think they can win this event.
Luke, absolutely. Week in and week out, this player has consistently performed at the highest level. I got to believe he's a lot of people's favorites to win this tournament.
Should find the green.
Four against the wind to stick that one.
We'll now move over to Xander Schauffele.
He's just coming off a drop shot on that last hole.
Okay, let's get back to the action. Oh, this will be good for the momentum. Let's make this birdie putt. Oh, what a round this is. 7 birdies today. And that will take him to 7 under. And still in top spot after that hole. Keep it going. Just a couple more inland holes before we head back to the ocean, Rich, the 15th.
Hitting it anywhere down the left-hand side off the tee, we'll find one of those deep bunkers, so you need to avoid those. Hit it out to the right, which will leave a great second shot into this green.
Tee shot looks pretty good. Time for the second shot at the 15th. Great shot. Trying to get to 8 under par with this putt.
Little birdie look in here.
Hey, nice looking line. And the putt drops, now at 8 under, heading down the stretch.
And just with the slimmest of leads out there, Luke, this will be interesting to see how they handle the pressure.
Now leading by one shot.
3 holes remaining, folks. Hang on to your hats. This is going to be a wild and woolly finish.
Rich, the 16th, not a long par 4, but really requires some accuracy on approach.
It does. Lay up to the top of the hill, and you can look down on this green, which pitches severely from right to left. Just a wonderful short par 4.
Well, that's right out of the top draw. A great shot from our leader. Playing this shot from 120 yards.
Downwind on this shot.
And back to the play, shall we?
And Henny, what's he facing with this one?
Our wind's just going to knock the ball down. It's straight at the back.
Oh, what a gorgeous looking shot that is, Rich. Oh, what a wonderful play, leading with intent.
Well, the practice is paying off here, Luke. This player is relentless.
Rolling end to end, this looking nice.
Super shot that. He's currently sitting in first place.
Two holes to go, Luke. Can they hang on?
Let's head to seven, one of the most famous par threes in all of golf, Rich.
Yes, just over 175 yards on the cart. It's a tale of two greens. When the pin is up front right, it's a birdie opportunity. Back left, find the green, make your three, and sprint to the 18th tee box.
To have chosen the 7-iron. That's a pretty handy shot. Oh, what a wonderful shot into the 17th. It sets up another putt inside birdie range. Frustrating. 6 feet remaining to the cup. That's tracking. Yeah, nothing to sweat over that one. We'll hold. Still in the lead now after that hole. Rich, as we find our way to the 18th tee, few holes in golf capture the imagination more than the finishing hole here at Pebble Beach.
So much history on this hole. Aim it at the trees right in the center and hope you don't get unlucky and get underneath one of them. From there, it's going to be a layup out to the right and just a short third shot. What a wonderful, wonderful finishing hole.
What kind of shot are they facing here, Henny?
The wind is at their back on this one.
Looks to be going with a hybrid here. Well, there's a very good reason why he's leading this tournament, and that's Exhibit A.
The iron play today has been absolutely stellar, Luke. The greens and regulation, just a fantastic accomplishment. Great to watch.
Like the look of this one. Well, you can start etching that name into the wall of champions, forever etched in history here at Pebble Beach. AT&T Pro-Am champion, well played.
And no better feeling, Luke, than to win on this classic layout. Pebble Beach Golf Links, a victory they will surely remember for the rest of their days.
I got to give props to my boy in the booth, Rich Beam. I think you picked this one at the start of the week, didn't you?
Luke, it's just, it wasn't a difficult pick, let's be honest. This player has been consistent all season long. Getting the victory, no surprise whatsoever. Really good stuff.
Well, that was a thrilling day. And on behalf of myself, Luke Elvey, Rich Beam, and all the hardworking folks at 2K Sports, thanks for your company. We look forward to the next time you join us.
Sports, in association with the PGA Tour, is proud to bring you the season-long race for the FedEx Cup. Today's coverage of the Waste Management Phoenix Open is about to kick off.
Delighted to have 2002 PGA Championship winner Rich Beam in the booth. I'm Luke Elvey, and it's a good morning to Henny Koyak, who's out on the course following our featured group.
Hi Luke, I'm pleased to be covering this featured group. We've got a fresh rivalry developing between these two players as well, so that should provide some great entertainment to the spectators this week.
So it looks like they aim to beat Justin Thomas. Should add a bit of extra excitement to our coverage today, Henny.
Oh, that goes without saying, Luke, but Justin Thomas will not be easy to beat. I don't think there's a more competitive man out there on tour.
No, you're absolutely right there. He's a complete player. It'll certainly be interesting to keep an eye on this rivalry throughout the event. Wow, that was just striped.
TPC Scottsdale, known for a bunch of birdies, Rich, and you can get right after them here at the first.
A gentle opening hole, second shot, a good opportunity to get your iron play dialed in. Green is very small. Anything missing to the right and to the left will run off into a collection area. However, if your irons are dialed in early, it's a great opportunity to make an opening three.
Ooh, just skinned the hole, that one.
Not a bad approach. Grab the putter from the caddy. You're dancing. What are we looking at for this putt, Henny?
Setting up this putt 15 feet from the cup.
Just didn't drop. Pretty good chance here. This one's for par. Well, that's a no-fuss par. They get the round underway, Rich.
Nothing wrong with an opening par, just easing their way into this round.
The second hole at TPC Scottsdale is a mid-range par four, playing 442 yards from the tips. The bunkers on the right side need to be avoided, which leaves a good mid-to-short iron approach to a green that is bunkered front, left, and right, so a good accurate approach required. Oh, well struck. This drive's heading for the fairway in my eyes. And this effort by Justin Thomas.
It's been neck and neck. He's actually tied with his rival. This is tough. Can he do it?
From around 140 yards here.
Wind is blowing from right to left here. Wants to work it against the wind.
Well, that'll work. Up on the dance floor. Could have been worse. Putting for birdie here.
Come on, don't be shy.
It was on a good line.
let's move on. A live look at the leaderboard, and Bubba Watson finds himself in top spot. The third here at Scottsdale plays over 550 yards from the tips. It's a strong par five, which requires two big shots to get to the green. The first shot needs to avoid that bunker on the left-hand side to give you a chance to go for the green. But if you're laying up, it's laying it back to a number between those two bunkers that sit on the left side of this fairway, around 150 to 100 yards out. Rich, I know it feels like we say this each week, but I just love being here in Phoenix. If there is one event on the tour that just seems to elevate itself beyond all the others because of all the people that come here to enjoy it, it's this one.
It is certainly a different event than all the others. Now, there's other tournaments that are trying to replicate what they do here in Phoenix, but none of them are successful with it. When you have as many as 650,000 people coming through the gates during the week, you know you're in for a different, unique opportunity here on the PGA Tour. And to play in front of all those folks, even though you know most of them aren't really watching you play golf, they're kind of looking around the crowds and being entertained by everybody else. Still, to have all those people just seemingly right on top of you, it gets to be a little nerve-wracking for some of these players.
Close was that to going in the hole. Great shot. Quality shot, that one. It's just about 3 feet away.
And that's a master stroke. It not only improves their position in the field, they're now ahead of their rival. Bubba Watson currently on top of this one.
The par three fourth at TPC Scottsdale. Fairly straightaway hole, but bunkers again. Front, left and short right requires a pretty accurate and solid strike. This one could take a little bounce to the left. Yeah, that was a safe play.
And this one for back-to-back birdies.
Sadly hasn't made a putt all day. Hopefully that can change here.
Looking for another birdie here.
So close. This putt just 5 feet away from the hole.
This is what they have left for a par.
And there it is.
Now let's switch our focus to Justin Thomas.
Yeah, he needs to press on that gas pedal. He's two strokes back from his rival.
Now just one over par. What a shot from the bunker. So after that effort, this is the current standings on the course. Bubba Watson currently in the lead. The fifth hole at TPC Scottsdale is a strong par four, playing 470 yards from the back tees. There's a big bunker down the right-hand side that'll catch any drive not hit with authority. The approach must be accurate with the bunker on the left-hand side. Anything just slightly missed here will be punished. lovely rhythm there, Rich. That's going to work every time. From around 180 yards out. Five shots off the lead.
Uh-oh, this one leaking out to the right.
It's fair to say that that approach didn't hit the mark.
Oh, the wind wreaks havoc with another golf ball.
Ooh, that almost went down. Well, that's very crafty, isn't it?
Such soft hands.
Opportunity to make their par. Now let's head over and see what JT's been doing.
He's two strokes behind his rival this week.
So after that effort, this is what the leaderboard looks like. Bubba Watson is atop the leaderboard with a two-stroke lead. The sixth hole at TPC Scottsdale is a solid mid-range par four. 432 off the back tees. And again, it's more position off the tee that's required here, with the bunkers on the left-hand side. A bold play is to fly it over that bunker on the left and leave just a short wedge in. Bold players will get after this hole, but a safe strategy lays back before them.
Good shot there.
This shot coming from around the 150-yard marker. Five strokes behind our leader. Opting for the 9-iron. Oh, that's a great approach shot.
And as good as they putt, you almost have to guarantee this one.
A chance to move into the top five on the leaderboard. A good putt to make.
This is on a great line.
Not sure if they understood the lie of the land there, Rich. And Henny, what are they looking at here?
Yeah, they've left it in the perfect spot here, just below the hole. They can be aggressive up the hill.
Ooh, right by the hole. A bogey putt awaits. Job done. Let's head to the next. Bubba Watson, our leader in this one. The seventh here at Scottsdale is a par three. A straightaway hole, the bunkers left and right of this green ensure that a nice straight shot is required. opting for the 5-wood.
This needs just a little work to the left-hand side.
This is an extremely long putt. You might even have to hinge on this one.
He's staring down a birdie putt here.
That one raced by. Bit of work coming back. 14 feet to the cup.
This really looks good.
And in it goes for the par. And this effort by Justin Thomas.
Yeah, he needs to press on that gas pedal. He's 2 strokes back from his rival.
Never seen a scorecard that doesn't look good with a 2 on it. So after that effort, let's have a look at the contenders and the pretenders. Bubba Watson is atop the leaderboard with a 1-stroke advantage. The 8th hole at TPC Scottsdale is a very strong par 4, playing over 475 yards from the back tee. There's a couple of pot bunkers down the left-hand side that need to be avoided so you can get to the green in 2. If you're going hard here, there's a tree on the right-hand side that can prevent a good second shot or a line to the green. 2 well-struck shots required to get to this green, and even then, your par's not secure. That's nicely done. Henny, what have they got in front of them here?
Setting up here from about 165 yards.
Going with the 7.
This player seems to not be too intimidated having Justin Thomas in their group today. That was a fantastic shot into this green.
This putt, a chance to move inside the top 20 on the leaderboard. Oh, gee, that line was looking good, wasn't it? Putting for a par now. That's a disappointing par in the end after such a terrific shot in. And as we check the leaderboard, it's great to see Bubba Watson back on top. The finishing hole on the front 9 at TPC Scottsdale was a par 4, measuring 453 yards from the back tees. There's plenty of room off the tee to the left, just so you can avoid that bunker on the right. There's a bunker short of the green here that needs to be avoided, a short little pot bunker. But 2 solid shots here will allow a chance for a birdie. Yeah, that one will play. Now let's switch our focus to Justin Thomas.
He's currently trailing his rival. Let's see what happens here.
Okay, time to return to the action. Justin Thomas, major champion, world number 1 player. Really has all the attributes, doesn't he, Rich?
He does. His focus on his own game is amazing. I think that this kid really understands how to play the game. He's got all the shots, but he doesn't try and get up there and hit it as hard as he can every single time. He gets out there and he learns how to play the game, hit the finesse shots when you need it, take some risks when you need to, but also back off when you don't need to. This kid is a real deal, complete game from head to toe.
Oh, I thought that one was going in. Oh, I like the look of that shot there, Beamer.
Just eyeballing that one, trying to make it.
Ooh, this would be a good one to make. It's for par. A bit too much pace on that one. This one just outside 7 feet to the hole.
On a nice line.
That's a bogey, but not a bad putt. Big bad Bubba Watson currently leads the field. The The 10th at TPC Scottsdale is a short par 4, measuring just 428 yards from the tips. There's a huge bunker down the right side of this fairway, which suggests maybe less than driver is necessary off the tee. What you want to do is set up for a good angle of approach, though. And there's a couple of pot bunkers to the short right of this green and a big one to the front left to be avoided.
Looks like they got all of that one. That's on a good line. Playing this shot from about 180 yards.
Breeze coming right into his melon.
Opting for the 6-iron. And he's not hit the mark on that approach.
A bit short with that effort.
Found the green side rough. Still, not a bad spot.
Wow, from a dodgy line ridge. How special was that?
Out of the rough, into the hole. Thank you very much.
And let's have another look at that one.
Now look how they attacked this one.
Now let's head over and see what JT's been doing.
Now, who'd have thought we'd see this? He is behind his rival. Can he do the catching up that's necessary?
And that'll move him to even par for the tournament. The 11th is a par 4, playing 472 yards and a huge water hazard down the left-hand side. The best line is a drive as close to that water without taking it on. Anything that leaves about 150 to 170 yards in will give you a chance to set up birdie. Couple of birdies and a couple of bogeys. Needs to get something going here today. This shot from about 190 yards out.
Wind moving the golf ball left to right.
A bit wild on approach there.
Bit too much club there, wasn't it?
Didn't that look good for a long time? Well, Rich, think they can make this one?
I really can't say I'm a fan of their chances on this one, Luke, but I tell you what, I've been wrong once before.
This is tracking right into the front of this cup.
And this effort by Justin Thomas.
Coming off a bogey on the last hole.
What's in front of them, Henny, with this putt?
Yeah, guys, he's got 28 feet here. He's got this for his par.
That was a gallant attempt. And after that effort, that's how it looks. Bubba Watson is one shot ahead of the field. The 12th at TPC Scottsdale is a par 3, measuring 192 yards off the back tees. Not much to this hole except the bunkers left to be avoided, although water can sneak in on the right up near the green if anything is slightly pushed. opting for the 5-iron.
Oh, this needs a little right turn, Clyde.
Always nice to have a birdie putt. Just missed. That'll sting a bit. A good opportunity here, just 6 feet to the hole. Looking good. Well, that'll maintain the momentum. Nice par putt. So, no movement on the leaderboard there, remaining at even overall. The 13th is one of the good scoring holes in the closing nine at TPC Scottsdale. It's a par five, measuring 558 yards. Job one is to avoid that huge water hazard to the right or the tree on the left-hand side that juts out into the fairway. If you're clear, you'll have a chance to knock it up near towards the green, or just laying it back to a comfortable yardage of around 100, 125 yards. A chance for birdie here to really ignite your charge. I like the courage here, Rich, getting after this par five in two.
As they should. What a play. Hopefully they'll be rewarded for that play.
That's disappointing. A chance to get amongst the action of the top 20. If this putt drops. This one's looking good. Oh, terrific. What an effort. And that will take him to one under. Now let's switch our focus to Justin Thomas.
Birdied their last hole.
Time for the fifth shot. It's time to check on the leaderboard. Our current leader is enjoying a one-shot lead. The 14th is a strong par four, almost measuring 500 yards from the back tees. The bunker that sits in the fairway should be covered. Anything around 190 to 200 yards out will give you a green light to go for this flag, although a four here never hurts. Time for the second shot at the 14th. One seemed to get away from them, Rich.
Oh, look at that. The wind just wreaking havoc with that shot. Disappointing.
Oh! Ha! Right at it from out of the bunker. And he needs this to save par.
Rolling end over end. This putt's looking great.
Just 3 feet to the cup.
They'll be happy to get this in the hole. This for bogey.
And a little slide down the leaderboard happening. Make sure you respond quickly. The 15th is a very important hole, the par 5, 553 yards from the back tees. Either makes or breaks a round here at TPC Scottsdale. That huge penalty area to the left is to be avoided if you're to make a decent score. A good drive will allow you to go for this island green in two. Although if you're too far back, no point taking it on as there's water everywhere to collect your ball. Laying up to the 115, 20-yard marker will give you just an easy wedge here and a chance to still make your birdie. Opting for the hybrid, I think. Even for the day. Playing their fourth shot. He's got a par putt here. Let's see if he can make it. Okay, steady now. And this one will be for bogey. Well, they're never nice, but that's the wrong time to go back-to-back with bogeys.
Two bogeys in a row, never a good sign. Now playing a little defensively.
Okay, as we move along, it's Lydia Ko in top spot. Welcome to the jungle, or as they call it here at TPC Scottsdale, the stadium hole, par 316. It's just a short club, but you miss the green, and a chorus of boos will ring out. With the 9-iron, I think. That was wonderfully done. Now let's head over and see what JT's been doing.
He's currently trailing his rival. Let's see what happens here.
Trying to get to even par with this putt.
This one's tracking.
Ooh. 3 feet to go here to the hole. And down it goes. And it's New Zealand's Lydia Ko who leads here as we head to the next. The penultimate hole of TPC Scottsdale is an absolute beauty. Do you go for it or lay up? A drive here that's just slightly pulled will find the hazard to the left. But if you're short right, a chance to get up and down for your birdie and really push for the title. Wow, what a shot off the tee. That set up a putt for Regal.
Oh, how about that shot? Taking out the big stick and going ahead and knocking her on. Love it.
Let's return to live play now. Okay, Henny, what's he looking at with this putt?
Careful not to leave this one short. It's back uphill, and nothing worse than leaving an uphill putt short.
Wow, that's misjudged. What an opportunity to make a birdie. Ouch, that hurts. That's not your best effort on the greens. Our leader is enjoying a three-stroke advantage. The finishing hole at TPC Scottsdale requires a great drive. The big water hazard down the left-hand side and the church pew bunkers make it a very difficult drive. Anything out to those bunkers on the right will leave a good angle approach. But once you hit this shot, make sure you get the right area on the green if you're to make your birdie. The approach into the final green at TPC Scottsdale is usually with a little bit of relief, Rich, because the water's behind you.
Luke, the second shot at the 18th is fairly straightforward, but how confident are you feeling with 50,000 sets of eyes focused on you?
Just a little off with the accuracy there, unable to find the green.
Missing it short there, they will definitely be upset.
Ooh, almost went in. Oh, what a wonderful bunker shot. This putt is for a score of 72. And that brings to an end his event. And Henny, no win for this player, but they set a goal and accomplished it by performing better than their rival. They've got to be pleased with taking down Justin Thomas.
Oh, that's right, Luke. This player challenged JT and beat him. That takes a lot of confidence, but also a lot of skill to pull off. Congratulations to them.
Well, another great day of action here at 2K Sports. On behalf of Rich Beam, the entire hardworking folks and team here, I'm Luke Elvey. We look forward to your company next.
2K Sports and the PGA Tour, proud to bring you the season-long race for the FedEx Cup. We're at the Genesis Invitational. Today's coverage is just about to begin. I'm Luke Elvey, alongside Rich Beam in the booth, and it's a hello to Henny Koyak down on the course following our featured group.
Hi Luke, great to be here. As this event kicks off, our featured group consists of two players who appear to have entered into quite the rivalry.
Well, this week, Henny, it looks like they're intending to beat the big-hitting Brooke Henderson. She might be a kind Canadian, but certainly a fierce rival.
Yeah, she's not going to say sorry. Just make sure you don't look in her trophy cabinet beforehand because you might get intimidated. There's some big major championships in there. Brooke Henderson, speaking of big, hits it big, got big game, and is just so lovely on top of it all. I almost don't want her to be beaten.
Yeah, she's a born winner, isn't she, Brooke Henderson? This is going to be a tough rivalry, but one if you can win will certainly build your confidence. Playing this shot from about 230 yards out. Opting for the 3-wood. You like that, didn't you? 12 feet to the cup coming up.
Fantastic play so far, setting this up for the eagle.
Just didn't drop. A chance for a birdie if this goes down. Nice line. Always nice to hold those for a birdie.
I've never been disappointed by starting off my round with a birdie, Luke, I can tell you that.
Currently one under for the round. We know that Riviera starts with a 5-4, but it may as well be a 4-5 because the par 4 second is tougher than the par 5 first.
I've never seen a golf course where you're so happy to start off birdie bogey. It's the strangest thing I've ever seen. The second hole, pretty straight away off the tee shot. The second shot moves a little bit from left to right, back up the hill. There is some space on the right-hand side to miss your second shot up by the green, but there's no guarantees that it'll kick hard enough right to left to get back on the green. It's a sensational second hole.
Well, what are we looking at with their approach shot, Rich? Because really, that's all the challenge here on this par 4 second.
Luke, the second shot is straight back up the hill. Better take an extra club if you want to get it close.
Looks to be going with the 6-iron. That's well played. Pin high. All right, Henny. What's he got in front of him here with this putt?
Can't be too aggressive here. Take your medicine and move on. This is down the hill.
This is a good chance. Just hammered that through the line. There's part of about 6 feet coming up. Oh, so close. This one for bogey. Was on a good line. Good putters will make these. Right on 5 feet. That was a gallant attempt. And this next putt is for triple bogey. And that putt will drop. Well done. And now over to Brooke Henderson's next shot.
She's currently ahead in this rivalry. Let's see what happens.
Sitting at a couple over for the day. Pacific Palisades in California, the site of Riviera, the third hole, par 4, elevated tee shot.
And a fairly generous fairway, a little bit more room out to the left than what players can see off the tee shot. Second shot is going to be downhill to a green that basically chases away from the player, going from the front portion of it all the way to the back. Difficult to get your second shot close here.
Rich, Canadian golf has had a number of people to be able to hang their hat on over the years. Obviously, most recent on the men's side, Mike Weir is a major winner. But the impact that Brooke Henderson has had on the game seems to have been even more significant.
It has been, and she doesn't carry the mantle just for women's golf in Canada. She carries the mantle for Canadian golf in general. She's such an amazing, delightful young lady to be around. Her personality is infectious. She's just a good soul. And she carries that around to the golf course. I mean, two-time major winner. But what I'm impressed about most with her game, Luke, is the fact that, you know, she is such a long hitter in the game. You don't quite see too many women in the game right now that they don't talk about hitting it long like we do in the men's game. But make no bones about it, she hits it a long way out there. That gives her a massive advantage over some of the other players. And that's why she is such a prolific winner on the LPGA.
Be nice to see this one go down. Let's see if they make it. Oh, what a big putt to make that one.
Love to see it. They hadn't been making anything all week long. Finally got one.
Moments like that deserve another viewing. Let's take a look at the replay.
Now this is how you putt. Take another look at this.
Catch up with Brooke Henderson.
She's currently one stroke better than her rival and playing partner today.
And stepping up the standings after that effort. So many wonderful holes at the George Thomas designed Riviera Country Club. This par 3 fourth has to be one of them.
This is a spectacular par 3. Ideally, players want to hit a tee shot that moves significantly from right to left and moving with the contour of the green. If they can do that, then they've got an opportunity to hit it really close. If they challenge the pin off the tee shot, well, it could come up short in that bunker, and that is a massive no-no.
Yeah, tidy-looking shot, that one. He didn't look to hit that one quite so flush.
Wind is absolutely swirling in this part of the golf course.
Well, that's an impressive little chip.
Gotta say, his short game is phenomenal.
A chance to save the par if he can make this one. Well done. Now five strokes behind. Rich, the PGA Tour is basically a power game these days, although the fifth here at Riviera forces players just to hold off the tee.
The fairway does run out about 310 yards off the tee, and players not necessarily going to hit driver here. They have to be mindful that the fairway pitches significantly from right to left on their tee shot. From there, they're hitting their second shots downhill again to a green that chases away from them front to back. Again, a simple looking second shot, but a difficult one to get close.
Oh, that was pure. From around 180 yards out, five shots off the pace. Yeah, not a bad effort, that one. Up onto the green and a chance to hole your putt.
Already made a few birdies today, and this is another good look.
Let's catch up with the current proceedings. Trying to get back to even par with this putt.
What a great opportunity here for a look at a birdie.
by the hole.
Putting for a par here. Trailing by 4 strokes. The 6th hole here at Riviera is very unique, isn't it, Rich?
Who puts a bunker in the center of the green? No one else except for the folks at Riviera Country Club. I love this hole.
Going with the 6-iron here. Sitting at 1 over. He has this putt to save his par. Oh, just missed. In she goes. Let's head to the next. The leader now has a 1-stroke advantage. Let's head to the par 4 7th at the Riv. Again, it's a par 4 that requires placement off the tee.
The fairway bunker down the left-hand side comes in quicker than you can imagine, and so players want to try and hit it out towards the far right part of it, but again, you push it a little bit and now the Barranca comes into play. If you find the fairway, happy days. This green is probably one of the most severe tilted from back to front. Players need to make sure their second shots land past this hole in order for it to come back down towards the hole. You will have a downhill putt, but it's better than coming up short.
It's a nice looking tee shot, that one. Sitting at 2 over for the day. Looks like they're going with the pitching wedge. That's inside the house of opportunity. And now over to Brooke Henderson's next shot.
She's currently in 4th place.
And back to the course with the live action. Let's see if we can make this big putt for birdie. Yeah, that looked to be a bit of a misread.
Well, I think they fell in love with the line, forgot about the pace.
And this putt coming up for his par.
You finished your work on that hole. Let's take a look at the next one. Lexi Thompson currently sitting in the lead as we check the rest of the standings. The par 4 8th at Riviera is a choose-your-own-adventure. Which fairway do you like to take?
I think most players are going to try and go down the left-hand side, as it seems to be the easier of the two these days. However, where they stick that flag stick, well, that's a different question. If they stick it up front right, the left-hand side of the fairway, that's not the easiest approach. So better be mindful of where that flag stick is in order to pick which side of the fairway you want to drive it down.
Lovely effort, that. And this shot from about 150 yards out.
The breeze is moving left to right up there.
Oh, golf clap. That's a beauty. What are we looking at for this putt, Henny?
18-footer here is what he's facing. This is what they have left for birdie here.
Okay, steady now. And just a little bit of cleanup work remaining on this hole. Sitting at 2 over for the event. The final hole on the outward half is a par 4 playing back up towards the clubhouse, Rich. That's a good par 4.
Only the big hitters are going to be able to carry that fairway bunker down the left-hand side. Most players are going to try and avoid it and even miss it the fairway out to the right-hand side, which is not a bad miss. From there, the second shot is directly uphill. Deep, deep bunkers on the front right part of this. That is not the place to miss it. Anything that a little bit long will leave you a downhill putt, but that's the safe play. No harm, no foul there with that shot.
And Henny, what are you seeing down there?
He is right on the 150 yard marker here.
To have opted for the 8-iron. This one looks like it'll safely make the green. Yeah, nicely played. This putt is about 15 feet to the hole. Ouch, that hurts. Just 6 feet between he and the hole. It's on a good line. Nice little putt to hole, that one. What do we catch up with Brooke Henderson?
She's currently in fifth place.
Here's Brooke Henderson's next shot. What a shot! Almost went in the bucket. So after that effort, let's take a look at the leaderboard. And as we check the standings, Lexi Thompson currently holds top spot. One of the most often discussed holes in all of golf is the par 4 10th here at Riviera Ridge. There's so much strategy.
It's either driver or 3-wood for every player in this field, but you better be good with distance because this green is very narrow.
Looks like a lovely little draw there. Just let that shot be water off a duck's back. Playing now from the fairway bunker.
And here we are with the third shot. How close was that to going down? Par-putt coming up here. And now over to Brooke Henderson's next shot.
Oh, she's taken the lead in this rivalry, but can she hold on to it?
And after that effort, this is how the field is shaping up. And one of America's finest, Lexi Thompson, currently leads this tournament. The par 5 11th, one of the better scoring holes on the course. Players are thinking four when they stand on this tee.
It's just a long straightaway par 5, almost a runway, if you like. Both sides of this fairway flanked by huge eucalyptus trees, which frames this tee shot brilliantly. You find the fairway, second shot, once again, straightforward. You must avoid that bunker front right at all cost. That is deep and nasty. You're not going to enjoy being in there.
Getting ready to play their third. Players setting up, trying to get up and down from the bunker. Footer.
Solid little par putt here.
Ah, that's frustrating. Just about 8 feet left to the hole.
This will be a good bogey.
Oh, what a stroke. And there it is. And it's Lexi Thompson on top of the standings here. When you stand on the 12th tee, Rich, you're thinking to yourself, oh, a couple of strong back-to-back par fours, and it starts right here.
This is where the golf course gets extremely difficult, Luke. This tee shot moves from left to right, but massive overhanging eucalyptus trees down the right-hand side prevents you from hitting a high draw over them. Once you're in the fairway, though, your second shot is to a green that's really not as big as it should be for such a long hole. And there's a famous tree just short and left of this green, Bogey's tree. Not because of the score, because Humphrey Bogart used to sit there and just watch everybody butcher this hole.
This shot from around 210 yards.
Has the wind coming right into his face.
Looks like they've got the 5-wood.
Clubbing up, smart. Gotta control it though. Let's see.
Seemed to lose the handle on that shot.
Oh, as we can see there, the wind definitely affecting that shot.
This is Brooke Henderson. Let's get back to it, shall we? And here we are with the third shot. Can you believe it? That's remarkable.
Nothing like it. Good stuff.
And it's time to recap that play.
Well, Luke, I think he's found his distance.
Current leader is enjoying a 2-stroke lead. Reached the 13th hole. Slightly different look off the tee.
It's really cool. This tee shot is framed by large eucalyptus trees, both right and left. Requires a draw. Nothing else to do. You have to move this golf ball from right to left off this tee. If you do it correctly, well, that golf ball could chase down there miles down this fairway. If you find the fairway down there, you're going to love the second shot. The difficulty gets when the pin is all the way back left in this little peninsula. You miss it a little bit left there, you're going to find the barranca, and you're probably going to find a bogey or worse.
Opting for the 6-iron.
Yeah, oh no, this one's left.
That's a tad wayward. Not quite finding the surface.
Yeah, wind took that one offline in a hurry.
Ooh, wouldn't that have been nice? Putting for par.
Looks good.
Just didn't drop. Good chance this one. Right on 6 feet. Well, that'll avoid a number of drop shots. Well, hold. Unfortunately, moving down the leaderboard, that's not the direction to be heading. The 14th, Rich, I know it's dear to your heart, the par 3. You made an ace there in tournament history, won a car. How do you tell the players to play it?
Hit a 7-iron, a high little draw 7-iron, and 2-hop it right in the hole, Luke. That's what I suggest. That makes it easy.
Looks to be going with the 6-iron.
Eh, it's Look out left.
No green in red, but a chance to save their par. And it goes in. Great shot. And that will move him up the leaderboard as well. That shot's so good, we need to have another look.
This one was a great chip in. I could watch this all day.
Why don't we catch up with Brooke Henderson?
Well, she's in fifth, and she'll want to climb from there.
Okay, let's get back to the action. Our leader is a couple of shots up at this stage. The 15th, Rich, a very good par four, although if you're Victor Hovland, maybe the fairway's not in your line of sight.
It's a great par four, and yet there's some players that have seen it a little bit differently lately. I always saw it as a dogleg from left to right, just avoid that fairway bunker down the right-hand side. And this is an interesting green. It's got a high spot on the left, and it's got a low middle section and a high section on the right-hand side, and you never have a flat putt. It is always breaking one direction or another, and it's either straight uphill or straight downhill. This is the most difficult green on the golf course by a long margin. If you see it differently, you can hit it down the right, down 17 fairway, but I fail to see how that's any kind of advantage.
Going with the 5-iron here. Nice shot, that. That should find the surface. Terrific shot into the 15th, and a chance for birdie. Well, Rich, from where I'm sitting, this looks makeable. Do you agree?
Luke, I got to say, I don't like their chances. I have been wrong once before, but I really can't remember when that was.
And that's back-to-back birdies as we head down the stretch.
Back-to-back birdies moving the right direction there, Luke.
Trailing by 7 after that hole. The 16th at Riviera Ridge is the last chance to get amongst the birdies on a par three.
A breathtaking short par three, 166, an island green surrounded by bunkers.
Looks to have chosen the 7-iron.
Trying to get it to move a little bit to the left here.
That's an absolute ripper. What a shot. And now over to Brooke Henderson's next shot.
She's currently in fifth place.
Okay, time to return to the action. And a chance to get back to even with the card with this putt. Oh, that's a nice line. Oh, I don't mind this par putt. And all of them are chasing Tiger once again as we move to the next. The last genuine scoring hole at Riviera is certainly this par 5 17th.
Any hopes of getting it home in two, you better come up with something special off the tee and make sure to avoid the bunker on the right-hand side.
getting ready to play their third. Well struck. What do we catch up with Brooke Henderson?
Well, she's in fifth, and she'll want to climb from there.
And back to the play, shall we? Trying to get to even par with this putt. Oh, gee, that line was looking good, wasn't it?
A par putt awaits.
Trailing by 8 strokes now after that hole. One of the most famous finishing holes on the PGA Tour, Rich, this 18th at Riviera is a classic.
Aim for the palm trees in the distance, which are located just on the left-hand side of the green. A good tee shot there will set up an awesome-looking second. Tempo there was exquisite.
Sitting at plus one. Within their comfort zone there. Chance to move up into the top 20 on the leaderboard. A good putt to make here. Oh, so close. And this putt for a final score of 72. And that'll be all she wrote today. Well played. Well, Rich, it's fair to say that this player didn't quite have their best stuff this week.
Not what the player was hoping for at week's end. Hopefully they can find some positives to take with them.
Well, that just about concludes our coverage. On behalf of Rich Beam, I'm Luke Helvey. Thanks for tuning in. We'll see you tomorrow.